Have we ever realized that victories play an important role in our life? No, not just that you attain the victory itself, but also it brings a challenge to climb higher. You don't want to be the laughingstock of people who saw you climb to be the manager of a company yesterday, and today you were demoted. No, I don't think so. You don't want that. Therefore, a victory is glorious in two ways: the achievement itself and the call for a higher challenge. Victory therefore spurs us to either maintain constantly the height we have attained or strive for a higher level, especially for victories having no limits. For example, making people happy. There is always a new unending challenge in this sort. Well, it is not every day we achieve great victories or big ones. For example, when we won, when we graduated from school, when we got married, when we got a job, when we got promoted or have a PhD, when we have our children. Every day is not Christmas, but then I can assure you, every day leads to Christmas. Now we must understand the importance of small victories, on a better way put, everyday victories. We actually recognize these victories, these small daily victories, because we are either filled with negativity so much that we are blinded from seeing them, or we term them as normal. We would say to wake up in the morning is normal, to laugh from a friend's joke is normal, to have friends is normal, to be sick and to recover is normal. The challenge to have to move higher daily to reach the so-called big victories are from these small victories. Unless one is conscious of these small victories, you cannot see a higher reason, a reason for a new higher challenge. Small victories add up to be big victories, just like each semester exam and assignments add up to having a degree at the end. The effects of small victories also give us a sense of co-responsibility in achieving societal victories. Each daily victory is important. We sense that we are not alone. Each person's struggle to achieve something great or small is what adds up to societal development. Peace in the society, for instance, is achieved also from each individual's contribution in ensuring peace in his or our family. Let me tell you something about life. Your victory is another's victory. Your failure is another's failure. So be wise and put your best in achieving your goals, because it is needed. Others need your victory to survive. A long line of people depends on your victory or success. Your quota of success is needed. Think about it, and you will see that it is true. Let me tell you some yet another thing about life as concerns victory. You need a leader. Trust me, without one who leads you to battle, one who guides you to the battle of life, to the battle which wins you victory, you will never succeed. In ancient times, when wars are being fought, every battle a nation engages, her victory is first and foremost ensured by almost, if not a perfect leader, who is a king or a queen or a warlord. Together with this comes the effort and cooperation of each soldier, whose contribution is invaluable. Now, even with weak soldiers, a good, perfect king or queen or warlord knows the strategy to win wars and gain victory over enemies, even using a small soldiers, his weak soldiers. In our daily life of battle, in our struggle to attain victory, we must acknowledge that we are weak and sometimes lose focus on our goals. We are limited and small. We surely can do something, but we also need the help of a perfect king or queen, one who leads us to battle of our lives and brings victory. We are incapable of taking the position of this perfect queen or king who leads us to victory, even in cases where we are in position of leading others under us. Think of the book of Judges, where the Israelites refused to go to war unless Deborah leads them to battle. Such is our daily battle of life, in which we need one who leads us to battle and without which we are bound to fail. We can depend and rely on the ultimate victory which Christ the King has won for us. We can also be rest assured that the Mother of God, the Queen of heaven and earth, and of all Christians, leads her subject to this ultimate victory of her Son, the King. She holds her hands. She trains her hands for battle with her educative powers. She maps out strategies for us. Strategies like, do whatever he tells you, as we saw at the wedding feast at Canaan. She leads us to battle, protects and defends us as a possession, as people belonging to the kingdom of her Son, and she leads us to victory. She never fails in that. Therefore, we should always call on her for help in all battles of life. Place a crown on her head to lead us as queen into battle in our work, in our families, in our school, in our nation, in everything, in every aspect of our life, in every area of trouble. Remember that your victory is needed. People depend on it. Generations are waiting. Therefore, your effort is needed. You cannot fail to deliver. And of course, you cannot deliver without help from the King and Queen who leads always to victory in every battle.